Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest on the Clash of the Champions tag team action set for one fall. Introducing team number one, parts unknown, 299 pounds, the Barbarian. His tag team partner, Kansas City, 251 pounds, Butch Reed. And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents. First, from Austin, Texas, weighing 261 pounds, the natural, Dustin Cruz. His tag team partner, from Sweetwater, Texas, 278 pounds, Barry Windham.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we know that Barry Windham and the Barbarian are in a real war. And Cactus Jack, we know you have no love lost for Dustin Rhodes, but this Butch Reed situation is a complete surprise.
It's a signal to Ron Simmons. See, this isn't the first time that Ron Simmons has been a world champion. No, he and Butch Reed were world tag team champions, but Simmons is trying to run away from his past, but he can't because he's standing there and his name is Butch Reed.
Rhodes with the momentum can't take the big Barbarian off his feet.
Look at that. Try it twice. Jesse can try it again and again. It's not going to work. He's not going to knock the big man down.
Barry Windham getting some momentum. Cody with a lariat. And there he goes down. Yes, he does go down. Hey. Reed's in. Double drop kick. Another double drop kick by the two twin Texas Towers.
Blatant cheap shot will knock even the strongest man down. A double team by Barry Windham and Dusty Rhodes can knock even the Barbarian down, but he'll get right back up.
Bottom elbow tie up. Windham in there with his rival, the Barbarian. Boy, what talent this Barbarian has. So big and strong and massive. And Windham's got him rolled up. Windham, the second-generation superstar from Sweetwater, Texas, got a near fall, Jess.
And that's what Windham's going to have to do. He cannot match up strength with the Barbarian. He's got to try to finesse him, and now he's getting caught in the wrong corner. And Barry Windham, the veteran he is, got out of that corner before Reed and the Barbarian could do the damage.
Well, yeah, Barry Windham's a great athlete, a great competitor, but he can't take on a team that has a plan, and that's exactly what Butch Reed and the Barbarian have a plan. It's not my plan. I'm merely a part of it.
Reed trying to muscle Dustin Rhodes back in the corner. Got those forearms to the ribs. A clubbing overhand forearm right to the back of the head. Irish whip taking the far side. And it shakes the ring, but Rhodes caught him coming in.
And Rhodes lifting up that big boot, catches Butch Reed, now switches him in the corner. Big right hands. Here's an Irish whip into the opposite buckle. Whoa, but no, Butch Reed.
Oh, my God.
And Dustin Rhodes all the way out to where Cactus Jack likes it best.
That's right.
The concrete.
Butch Reed may be a little rusty, but in the end, talent shall prevail, and that's exactly what it's doing. Dustin Rhodes in a lot of pain.
Rhodes trying to beat the count back in. He's got a count of 10 to get back in there. Hacksaw Butch Reed going out to give
slam
him
an unfriendly
hand.
He won't be so merciful next time, I guarantee you that. Dustin Rhodes is going to learn about loss.
Rhodes needs to make the tag, no doubt about that. And look at the teamwork here, Barbarian and Hacksaw Butch Reed.
Double clothesline.
And what they did there, they finessed Windham into the ring so that they could double team and do the damage. You know, lots of times when you get a partner into the ring, he's actually more of a bother to you than a help to you.
I got a little saying. It says you can fool some of the people some of the time, but you can fool Barry Windham all of the time.
Great strength by the Barbarian. 295, 299 pounds. You might as well say he's a 300-pounder. And what great agility for Dustin Rhodes, the young son of the American Dream. Dustin Rhodes back up vertical, trying to fight back with all he's got. But the Barbarian is so big and so powerful.
Well, I think the Barbarian also gave him a shot to the throat right there, because you saw Dustin Rhodes stagger and go down to a knee when it looked like he was having some type of advantage. But I'll tell you, the Barbarian's a veteran and, without a doubt, the most powerful man of the four in the ring.
Yeah, just to go to Barbarian and Butch Reed, because in honesty, Dustin Rhodes and Barry Windham were training for the Barbarian and Danny Spivey. But if you will recall, that's how our world champion Ron Simmons got the edge.
Tremendous display of power by the Barbarian. Dustin Rhodes trying to hang on here. He's going to be physically challenged. The tag has been made. Here comes the veteran from Warrensburg, Missouri, Hacksaw Butch Reed. Dustin reaching to make that tag. Barry Windham, they got close, but No cigar.
Dustin Rhodes got a lot of guts.
Beautiful, beautiful reverse neckbreaker. This could be it.
Could be over, but he got two. Just got two that time. When Rhodes able to kick out.
I'll tell you, you got to give Dustin Rhodes, the natural, a little credit, too. I see him so many times where I don't think there's no way he's going to kick out, and somehow he manages to snake that shoulder off the canvas and avoid a three count.
I'm sure that if Ron Simmons is out of the shower, he's really getting an eyeful here from this big barbarian and his former partner, his former friend, Hacksaw Butch Reed, who's putting those big right hands right to the face of the natural.
Take a look, Ron. Take a good look. Destiny's looking you right in your miserable little eyes.
I'm sure Dustin's grandma in Houston, Texas, is sitting on the edge of her seat here as Reed rakes at the face of the youngster from Austin. He has been in there for a long, long time, and he has been punished by two big, powerful men.
Well, again, I've said it many times, the key to tag team is cutting off the ring and keeping one guy in the ring longer than he should. And right now, Dustin Rhodes, if he don't make a tag pretty soon, it's all over but the crying.
Yeah, I may have been selling Dustin Rhodes a little bit short. I thought it'd be over by now, but this kid's got a lot of resiliency. He's taking Cactus Jack to the limit, and it's about time I jump in there and slap him around myself.
I don't think that'd be a good idea, you doing color and going to the ring. Oh, it might be expensive.
I'm a professional, Ross. You can expect me here to share my wisdom.
Jesse, how much more can Dustin Rhodes sustain of this?
Not much. Look at the Barbarian almost slams him through that mat, lines him up, drops the big elbow on him. This has got to be it.
One, two, he's got it!
No, he got 2.5.
Beat him! Beat him!
I'll tell you, Dustin Rhodes being about 6'6", 6'7", he's got that leverage to where if he kicks his legs hard, he can manage to stay out of the pin. Look at double axe handle by Hacksaw Butch Reed as he comes off that second rope legally.
I tell you, Ross, calling up Butch Reed may have been the best move I ever made. Like I said...
Did you think of this yourself?
Oh, no, it wasn't my idea. I'm just playing a part. Like I said, when you're Cactus Jack, you don't have to have a reason, just an opportunity, and that's what they're doing to Dustin Rhodes.
Ah! Rhodes got the elbow in. Boy, this is tremendous action, like you'll see in cities like Dallas and Chicago, Cleveland, Oklahoma City, Charleston, West Virginia, Baltimore, the Omni here in Atlanta on Sunday, September the 20th. Don't miss WCW when it comes to the ring near you. Good elevation. But how much did that take out of Dustin Rhodes?
Well, Rhodes needs to get across and tag Wyndham, and here's his best chance to do it. And he failed again.
I'm going to see this. I'm going to see it loud enough so Butch Reed can hear. Butch, we proved our point. Finish him. Down.
Oh, both of them. Double clotheslines there. They both found their mark. But again, remember that Dustin Rhodes has been there in the ring for a long, long time. Reed and the Barbarian have made many, many tags, and Reed's about to make another one. He does make the tag of the Barbarian. And he makes it. He got the tag. Wyndham in, fist and fire. Takes him up, power. Nails Reed, who tried to come in.
And Dustin Rhodes been resting a long time. He's got a head of steam, and he's taking a drop kick.
Barry Wyndham taking on both Reed and the Barbarian, but how long is he going to be able to do that?
He got the lariat. He got all of it there. What a war between these two.
He should have tried to finish it right there. There's no way he doesn't have the time on his hands to fit the superplex on the Barbarian.
Wyndham going for the superplex, and he got it. He got it. He floats over. But look at Reed. Wyndham saw Reed out of the corner of his eye and slams him right off the top. Wyndham and the Barbarian, the legal man. Dustin Rhodes back in.
All four men in the ring. And as you said, Jim Ross, Wyndham and the Barbarian are legal. Double drop kicking. Hacksaw Reed out to the floor.
Oh, he caught him in the face. He kicked him right in the face. He's put his lights out. The Barbarian kicked him in the face. And
ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners, the team of Butch Reed and the Barbarian.
A tremendous boot by the Barbarian on Barry Wyndham. He caught Wyndham with that boot and knocked him cold. Let's go back to replay. Here you see Wyndham turning around. Wham! Look at the boot, about a size 14, right to the jaw. Will knock any man in the world out. Barbarian hooking the leg. 1, 2, 3, and a big win for the tag team. And now, let's go to my colleague, Jim Ross.
All right, thanks very much, Jesse, the Body Ventura Boy.